Now that you know about branches and reachability, you know everything you need to in order to understand the entire detached head message we saw earlier. Remember, to get this message, we checked out a commit, not a branch. Remember that head just means current commit, so head now points to this commit. First, git says that you can look around and make experimental changes and commit them. You now know that git's history can be nonlinear, so if you commit changes, they would look like what we saw before, here, and head would get updated to the commit that you just made. Next, it says that you can discard any commits that you make in this state without impacting any branches. Since this commit isn't included in any branches, it won't show up in git log. It's not reachable, and the changes made here don't show up in any of the branches. And like we said before, if you then checked out an actual branch, it would basically be like this commit never existed. The next bit says that if you want to create a new branch to retain these commits, you can do so by using this command, git checkout-b new branch name. Running git checkout-b is equivalent to running two commands. First, it's just like running git branch new branch name, and then running git checkout on that new branch. Since this sequence of commands is something that people will want to do pretty often, pretty much every time you're making a new feature, it's nice that there's this shortcut for it. If we do either version of these commands while we're still on this commit, then the new branch would be created here. Then any further commits would be on this new branch, since we already know that making new commits brings the branch with us. This last line just reminds us what commit we're on by giving us a shortened version of the commit ID, and then tells us what the commit message was. Great! Now you understand the entire warning.